All right, everybody, welcome back to the garage, and I hope you're all having a good day. Today we are going to be playing with some of this stuff. It is Toyota's seal packing, FIPG. What we're going to be doing is playing around with the gaskets I installed the other day. Obviously, I still have a vacuum leak somewhere. So I'm going to put some around the throttle body gasket. And I'm not very confident in my job that I did when I put the red intake manifold on the car, so I'm going to take that off and scrape off the old gasket, put a new gasket on there using some of this FIPG stuff from Toyota. And then we will see if that does the trick. Stick around. Maybe I will learn something. And I gotta say, I'm not a mechanic. I'm just a guy who likes to work on my car. And so if I do things wrong, it's because I don't know always what I'm doing. And I have some guesses here and there, and I read stuff, but I don't always know exactly what I'm doing. So, come learn with me. All right, in order to change the intake manifold gasket, intake manifold, big red thing. I need to take the throttle body off, and I need to take this EGR off as well. And then I put some goop around here when I'm putting it back together. Now I had bubbles coming out of the throttle body shaft. I still don't have a solution for that, so I'm not sure if that ends up being a big problem. I just don't know what I'm gonna do. We'll try that. Hopefully that fixes some vacuum leaks. Then, if that is still a problem, then I'm going to be checking out some other things. Some people suggested I check out the, what do they call it? The, check out the water housing thermostat, which is this green plug right here. This guy right here. So we may need to check out that. Maybe that's gone bad. Or maybe it's this guy right here, water temperature housing. Do I have two? Yeah, two. Those could be bad and sending a bad reading to the computer. My computer could still be messed up too. There's a lot of things that could be going on here. Let's go exploring. So you've seen me take this off in other videos, so I'm probably not going to show you how to do that. Basically, it's 4 bolts. First take the intake tube off, and then it's 4 bolts, and then that comes off, and then I can get to the nut that takes the EGR pipe off. Once that's loose, then I will lift the car up, and then there's 7 bolts along the intake manifold gasket. All right, I've got the throttle body off, which is pretty easy, and then I got the EGR off, which is again not that difficult once you get into it. And the last time when I changed to the red manifold, intake manifold, I didn't do this, but I'm gonna see if I can point it out to you guys here. Right down here where my finger is, can you see it? Is where one of the bolts for the intake manifold is, and it's really hard to get to from the bottom, but I'm just thinking if you can get to it, but when you take the throttle body off like I just did, I can get my ratchet in there, that will make life a lot easier. See if you can see it from this angle here. Yeah, it is right there. And you can look on the camera. So there's where the EGR gets undone, and that's where that bolt is there, or the little nut. Okay, for this nut, it's down here, it's on the top, it's on the very end. I have my ratchet set up. I have my ratchet set up right there. And it goes to the back, and then I got it on there. Just enough room in there to get everything. I don't even know if you guys can see my ratchet set up. Right there's the handle right here. I got a little bit of an extension, and it goes onto that one there. It's quite difficult to get up in there, but once you get it up in there, it's okay. We'll take that off, and then I think I can get everything else from the bottom. We'll see here. Okay, so now I'm gonna take off the vacuum lines are here. These guys here. Probably should take off the, what do they call this guy? The cold start injector. And then this is the bracket for the cable. For the throttle cable. And then everything should be disconnected up top. And then we can lift the car up and get the last of the... Okay, so I got all the bolts undone on the bottom. Now I should be able to just pull this up and out. And then, if I did everything correctly, there's still more things connected. There is one more thing. Get out of here. Crud. Okay, I think I might put it back up in the air and then undo one more bolt. Okay, so there is one more bracket on the bottom. Now this shit should come out. Ah, Brad. One more. Always one more. Thought I'd gotten everything off of the top. There's a little nut that holds the wiring for the injectors. That needs to come off. There we go. Or not. Okay, what did I do last time to get this out? There's a harness on the alternator that's got to come off. So that's what I got to do. Okay, it's going to be a bit hard to see, obviously, like they all are. But the alternator plug and top post needs to be disconnected. This little blue connector needs to be undone. And then this little red connector needs to be undone as well. There was a bracket up top of the intake manifold that needs to be done. It's all because this wiring harness goes through the middle of the manifold. So all those little guys have to be done, taken off. Okay, so now I'm gonna take the intake manifold off. Then I'm probably gonna have to take the car back up in the air and then I can take off the old gasket and put the new one on with the goop. I'd say all in all, I've got probably I'm probably about 2 hours in because I'm taking my time and I'm not very good at this and I forget things and then also filming and that kind of stuff. The very first time I took this manifold off, I didn't have a lift, so getting access to the bolts and stuff was really difficult. I also didn't lift the car very high with the jack stands, so obviously the higher up you can go, the better. Anyways, we'll take the manifold off and then we'll inspect the gasket surface. All right. Now we can do this, right? Once more for the fourth time. What's the problem? Somebody else? Oh no, just caught up on a line. How did I do this the last time? Man, I remember it being a lot easier. Got the wiring harness up in there. Okay, there we go. All right, first time taking it out. I see a lot of oil pooled up there. Like there's a oil leak or something. That smells like gas. That's like raw gas sitting in there. Okay.
Whoa, come back.
Okay, so that's raw gas sitting in there. So I'm not sure exactly what that means, but we'll clean up this And we'll put this in the air and we'll see what the bottom main surface looks like.
Okay, let's take a look up in there. I don't know if you can see it. Okay, so it looks like there's a rip right here in that gas right there. Hopefully you guys can see that. So that looks like that's probably the big problem right there. So we have a new gasket. We'll take this one off and we'll put it in. It looks like there's stuff leaking out around there. I don't know if it's so far so good or it's just so far. Oh, my battery's dying. I'm gonna have to take a break because there's some gasket on there and I've got most of it off except for some bits and pieces. And so I've decided to get some of this stuff. I read online that it's supposed to work. Of course, that's online and it says it's good for that. The scraping of the gasket has taken the longest, like the absolute longest. It was like a paper gasket and it just stuck permanently to the cylinder head. So I'm going to have to try and let this soak for a while and then we will go from there. So as of now, it's taken me probably, the first time it took me a couple hours, and then now it's taken me probably about 5 hours because I've been scraping gaskets because it's just frustrating. So I will spray this on. Hopefully it works. Well, the Permatex gasket remover seems to work pretty good. I got one spot I cannot get off. So I'm not sure how big of a deal it's going to be. I'm going to now take some of the Toyota gasket maker that I got, wherever I put it, and put it around all the ceiling surfaces around here, and I'm going to place it onto the manifold, and then I'll drop the manifold down on top of, and then once this is in place, then I'll put some of the gasket maker on the other side of it, and we'll go from there. Hopefully I can do this without too much trouble because I don't want a whole lot going in to I don't want goop bleeding into there, so maybe I'll just put it around the outside here, the very outside, and then that should keep it running. And then this side goes like that. I imagine that's how it goes. Okay, so it's a little bit bigger. So, imagine that's the part that crushes, and then that's where the actual seal comes from. The paper gasket had these filled in. Interesting. This is my first time doing this with the gasket sealer, so we'll see how it goes. I just cut the first nub off. It's like, again, I don't want to have a lot come out. At least that's my thought pattern. Side. Now
Unfortunately, it's hard for me to show you what I'm doing, just camera angles and all that, so I'll show you when I get it on there.
One good thing is that stuff holds it on there nice. It's nice and sticky. Looks like I'll have good coverage. Now I'm gonna carefully try to put some around the outside so that when the intake manifold gets squeezed onto the head, it has a bit of sealing around that as well. I want to do that because when I drop the head in or the manifold in, it's a little difficult
to keep the stuff from smearing.
Okay, so there are four ports, a little bit of goop on each one on the outside. I'll lower the car, put the manifold in like that.
Okay, so full disclosure, it's now a new day, only because I got tired last night. I shouldn't have taken so long, but family stuff showed up. It was family movie night where we had pizza and watching a movie with the kids and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, you gotta do that. Plus, I wanted to let that goop dry, cure on there overnight. So I'm gonna put the car down, and then I got one little bracket. I had lost a bolt, and so I put the car back up in the air and I'm gonna do this little bracket. Once the car's down, then I'm gonna put this little bracket on the intake intake tubing. Gonna put it on and gonna start it up. All right, party people, we're gonna get this car started up. I decided I was gonna put some cool rocket thrusters on my car. Actually, just some dryer vent to get the exhaust outside. Hopefully, well, see, air pressure just blows stuff in, so I don't know if that's gonna work or not, if it's gonna get the exhaust out or if the wind's just gonna blow it in. For some reason, the way that this garage is set up, things just blow into the garage. So without further ado, I'm gonna start it up and see if she makes any difference. Okay, well, now I feel like I've totally screwed my car because something is wrong now. I put the key into the ignition and I just turned it over to accessory and it wants to start. And I didn't change anything electrical. All I did was unplug the battery and then I plugged the battery, like hooked the battery back up. So I'm not sure what electrical things have changed, but something has changed and it's wanting to start the car as soon as I put the key into the accessory position. Very odd, very strange.
All right, I'm gonna record this. I'm not sure if this is gonna be the problem or not, but obviously it shouldn't be there. See if I can reach up. This guy right here that I'm dangling should be up on one of these guys here, like that, like a ground wire. It obviously wasn't, so I'm gonna put that up in there and see if that is the hard starting problem.
Okay, so I touched that ground wire. We will now see if anything changed. Thank you. Okay, fantastic. A, it was the ground wire. That was awesome. Ground wire, and then it already sounds better starting up. So this is fantastic. I'm gonna let it idle, maybe take it around the block, that kind of thing. Start it, open up the door, let it idle for a while, and then we'll see if it does bring it up to operating temperature, and we'll see if anything happens up.
All right, so final results. It looks like replacing the intake manifold gasket has solved the problem of the surging. I'm up to operating temperature now, and it doesn't seem to be doing that hunting, the whoom, whoom. But now I have a bit of a high idle, so I'm not sure what's going on with that. Again, we're gonna try this out. At least I've narrowed it down there. So, in all, the highs and the lows, the ups and the downs, the crashes and the booms. Thank you all for your suggestions. It turns out it was a vacuum leak. It's much more stable now. It's not as erratic as it was before. This is actually quite, even though it's a little bit high, it's about 500 high, it's way better and it's way punchier and snappier. When I did my little test drive, things are better now than it was, even though it's got a high idle. So now I just gotta track that down and go from there. All right, thank you once again for everybody that has helped me out.